His work for Opeth is more spicing it up, and mostly for the clean vocals, because he's so good with vocal arrangements and vocal harmonies and stuff like that.
Is that right? Is that right?
Sort of, yeah.
I can't remember the first one.
Do another. And this is the moment of its birth. Will it turn out to be
bollocks?
A prodigy or a problem child? It depends on the part. I mean, sometimes we experiment with harmony vocals, sometimes experiment with interlocking vocal parts, different sounds for the vocal. Mike's very fond of one of the things I do a lot, which is make voices sound like a telephone, you know, what's come down a telephone. So, you know, it's a case really of trying to find a unique sound world for every part. And I do a lot of that using hard disk technology, computer technology.
It's going to be nice.
It's going to be nice, yeah.
Some
more
tuning.
A bit more tightening up, a little bit of tuning, and it'll be great. I'm just wondering whether I shouldn't add my voice to the mix.
Yes.
Oh, fuck, that one's to get the C, isn't it?
It's hard.
Yeah.
So it's not just me.
It's not just you, man, no, yeah. I think the tune will fix that, so let's do the third.
Okay. Here we go. Here comes the Apple Z.
That's a hand.
Here we go.
Big and it'll be nice. It'll be lush.
Lush.
Yeah, very lush.
And tight?
I'll have to do a bit of tightening.
How tight will it be?
It'll be tight as a witch's cleft. Yeah, sounds pretty nice, yeah. So I'm going to delete all the takes now because that's a stereo bounce. Oh, yeah.
I've been playing percussion since I'm 4, I think. Like South American, Uruguayan percussion. We have a drum called called tamboril, and that's, you know, what I've been playing the most.
Years later, after my aunt rehearsed, it's like they're such an important part of this band that it's almost weird. You know, they bring in some influences I never would have gotten otherwise, like, because they live in what could be considered the ghetto of Stockholm, called Rinkeby, and they had lots of friends from different cultures who play music to them, and they in turn play to me. No, we don't have many fights, you know. We try to keep away from each other when we're back home.
We argue about ridiculous things, like if you have a relationship, what do you argue about? Just, you know, stupid things. And since we spend so much time together on tour, we could argue about, you know, bullshit things.
We had our little bitch fights, but, you know, like, never anything serious. I think the only fight we had in this band, not fight but discussion, like, we screamed to each other the only time, it was Peter and I about
dishes once when we recorded
Blackwater Park.
That's like the worst fight we ever had.
I see other bands, we were in two other bands, and I see they have a lot of problems, and I think we have very good relationship in the band, yeah.
The eternal fight is about the air condition. Mendes and I, we want the bus to be boiling hot. We want to walk around in shorts, without shirts, and have the tropical climate in there. And the guys, they're like polar bears, you know, they have it like air conditioned to the top, and they live in the little igloos. When you record an album and with a band that you rehearse every day with, you know what's gonna come out. You know, it's like you just can't. The only thing you don't know is the sound. So the only thing you can progress with is the sound. But when you're recording albums like this, it's like an adventure. You know.
It's like being back in school, you know, having mathematics, you know, it's like, it's so boring, and, you know, it's like, I don't know, it's nothing even remotely funny or interesting in recording drums, unless he's doing a very nice and long, fantastic take, you know.